So today I'm talking about rootstock.
Should you care about rootstock?
Well, I think you should care.
Why?
Let's see this video.
Diego. Oh God, the internet about you again? Jesus. Enough of that. Diego.
Sorry, I don't, every time I see that video, it gets me, I don't know what to say. I just really feel this sense of that token fever. This conference has been so damn tough for me. I mean, we've been working on this for so long, and I just want everybody to enjoy themselves. So, here, everybody needs to come with me to the back to see our demo. Come with me. Oh, that was great. Oh, God, I love you, man. All right.
Well, what are you up to? Let's see. So, what you want to do, they're building a kind of system here. Okay, how do we mesh the features of Ethereum? And how do we bring them to the Bitcoin platform? Now, I think what they are doing is very, very good. When you look at many of these blockchain parts, like, oh, they say Bitcoin cannot do this. We want to bring in our own, we want to create in our own blockchain and all that. So the question is, why create another blockchain? Or, okay, why create another coin and populate the whole market with thousands of coins? So what ROOSTOCK is seeking to do is, okay, we see Bitcoin is not really Tory complete. We see Ethereum is Tory complete. We see Bitcoin has some lapses, like, okay, we can only transfer value with it. Though that does not mean you cannot write some script language. And then you see Ethereum, oh, you can transfer value. You can do a lot of things with it, build decentralized applications. That is what ROOSTOCK wants to bring. So ROOSTOCK wants to bring in the Ethereum features, smart contract, decentralized applications, to the Bitcoin network. Now, ROOSTOCK would not go by the hard fork. Like, it takes a lot of time, takes a lot of resources to actually go by the hard fork. People will have to upgrade, and it's not really, really the best idea. So what are they seeking to do? They are seeking to bring the stocks of side chains. And they've been working on this product, if I'm not mistaken, from 2015 up to now, right? So as you can see, there will be no coins created with the ROOSTOCK. However, Bitcoin will be used as value for mining settings. So there will be mesh to mining. They will be benefiting from the security features of Bitcoin being the highest and the most secure blockchain network out there. You saw the issue that Vesh actually had a kind of system where 51% attack actually occurred, which is not really a good one. And then another thing again about ROOSTOCK is that ROOSTOCK seeks to be backward compatible with Ethereum. So what that means is, let's say for example, you create smart contracts in Ethereum and there are certain features you want to actually benefit from ROOSTOCK. What that means is you can simply copy the code and paste it in ROOSTOCK and you can actually get the benefits of that. So all the benefits of Ethereum. Ethereum has a community of developers, they have people research, they have all this. What that means, what you are creating on Bitcoin, or on ROOSTOCK, sorry, ROOSTOCK is going to make it possible, just like you're connecting Bitcoin and Ethereum. So they are the system they want to do. So you're not just creating smart contracts or decentralized applications on the Bitcoin network. They can also work on the Ethereum network. And that is a very, very good one. Another thing again is Federation. So Federation is, they will be using that to provide, it will be adding like security checkpoints. And not only aside that is security checkpoints, but also things like back-end solutions or back-up solutions for institutional users or banks and whatever platforms and that. So I think they have a goal to connect the whole world. What I talk about is the internet of value. How do we connect the whole world to the blockchain? And you ask, okay, Bitcoin is very, very good. Why don't we use the Bitcoin? And as it can process like 100 transactions per second. And then there is something I want you to know about. You can become a beta tester. As you can see here, we are happy to announce our partnership with Jaxx, the first highly secure and easy to use wallet supporting RSK smart bitcoins. So be part of our beta testing program and have the unique opportunity of being the first to use this online application secured by Bitcoin network. So what's the step you follow? You download the Jaxx wallet and then you become a beta tester. You register your address here. Let's see how it goes. You register your address here. You download the app. So you download the mobile app. I think it has Windows also. And then the next step is, so we will transfer it to, so just go there, download it, whether from Windows or your phone and all that, and then register, submit your address and all that. So it's going to be a very big platform. They transfer it to you and it's going to be very, very rich. I'll do that after this video. And then another thing again about this platform is they are bouncing. So maybe you are a kind of security expert or you know about codes and all that. You can submit and go through the code. Here are the rules. And actually submit a vulnerability and all that. Okay. And moving on, we have this. There are a lot of stuffs out there about N.com. Some people are saying that N.com was actually a kind of wasteful platform, that they invested, I think, 100 and something million for a platform like this and it failed. And even this platform, this and that and all that. And you know, somebody was making a statement and was like saying, if that money had been invested in Bitcoin, it would have been this. If that money was invested in Ethereum, it would have been this and all that. And there are things we fail to understand. Like, if you look at the growth of Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies or blockchain in general, if you see so far, it's the issue of community. People have been building stuff. People have been involved in research. How do we make this thing more secure? How do we make this thing more good? How do we bring investors who have money? Okay, how do we bring institutions that we use? Because it's one thing to invest something, there's another thing again to adopt. We get to adoption and all that. And what people fail to realize is when Google actually bought YouTube, when I listened to the story and all that, when Google bought YouTube, I think YouTube was not even making money. Yeah, YouTube was not making any money. But they just bought it because they saw the potential in this platform. So they saw the potential in this platform and they actually bought the platform and they worked around it and they made it very, very, very good. And you can add this to YouTube you see today. Then they brought all the monetization and all that. So for the people who are actually talking about, oh, this platform is a waste, no. I use N.com. And at N.com, I think, and you might not see it now, let's not judge by the money and all that. N.com is a platform, considering the team and all that, it's a platform for the future. The future of email is N.com. This is, we already have email marketing, but we're talking about the future of email. When Google bought YouTube, Google did not know that they were buying. YouTube is the second biggest search engine in the world. They did not know that they were buying something that would become the second biggest platform in the world. There was a company that had no revenue. How much did they buy them? I think for $2 billion. Look at WhatsApp. Facebook bought WhatsApp. Question is, Facebook started making money from WhatsApp. No, how much did they buy it? I think $1 billion. I know that. So, pay attention to the platform like this, n.com. Always pay attention to the trends. Always pay attention because Tim Draper said something that when you invest in companies, ask you, okay, this your idea is good, okay. How many people know about it? If you say, well, a lot of people know about it, they say, no, it's too late for me to coin. No, yeah. If everybody knows about it, if everybody acknowledges it, then it's too late. It is when people have not acknowledged it, that is when you can actually use it. And then moving on, I want to talk about OneCoin. Now, there are people who are watching this video all over the world and all that. Sorry, not One Life. So I want to talk about the billion coin and then platforms like OneCoin. And there are other platforms also. I've done a lot of videos to actually teach you on how you can actually go about investment. So if you are watching me, I will advise you that you stay away from platforms like this. OneCoin, a billion coin, that platforms that don't have any business model behind them. And you just see people, you don't know who is behind them and all that. So I will advise as a person, stay away from platforms like this, OneCoin and the rest of them. And if you do that, you will be safe. So if you like this video, consider subscribing and do have a very good day.